Ladies and gentlemen, may I present the Deputy Lieutenant of Surrey and the Worshipful, the Mayor of Reigate and Banstead.
Please be seated. Honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, we come together this afternoon following the passing of our late sovereign, Queen Elizabeth II. Our sadness at this time is shared by people across the globe, as we remember with affection and gratitude the lifetime of service given by our longest reigning monarch. But the basis on which our monarch is built is ensured that through the centuries the crown has passed in an unbroken line of succession. Today's ceremony marks the formal proclamation to the people of the borough of Reigate and Banstead of the beginning of our new king's reign. The proclamation of the new sovereign is a very old tradition that can be traced back over many centuries. The ceremony does not create a new king. It is simply an announcement of the accession, which took place immediately on the death of the reigning monarch. In an age where modern methods of communication convey news around the globe in an instant, the proclamation is no longer the means by which people learn for the first time they have a new monarch. Today, however, is one of the first occasions when communities have an opportunity to come together and reflect on the moment in our nation's history when the reign of our longest serving monarch came to an end and our new sovereign succeeded. In today's proclamation, the mace will be inverted. There is a tradition that when the monarch visits a borough, the mace, which is the symbol of the mayor's authority, is inverted in recognition of the authority of the crown. We will invert it today as a similar signal of recognition that the crown has passed from our late sovereign to her successor. I will now ask my chaplain, Reverend Hoff, to say prayers.
Pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we come to you in sorrow at the death of our sovereign, Queen Elizabeth II. We acknowledge with thankfulness her fulfilled promise to live a life of faithful service to our nation and to the people of the Commonwealth. We are grateful for the blessings and the freedoms that we have enjoyed under her rule. We thank you for the sense of stability that she has brought to our nation and the nations of the Commonwealth in times of trial and trouble, and for the affection in which she was held among the people of this nation and around the world. We praise you for the courage that she showed in testing times, for the depth of her Christian faith and the witness she bore to it in word and deed. Heavenly Father, meet with all who are mourning today. May that faith in you which inspired and sustained the Queen inspire, sustain, and comfort all who mourn. In this period of national mourning, may we share her quiet confidence in your sovereign hand upon us. Amen. In the Bible, we read of God that he controls the course of world events. He removes kings and sets up other kings. He gives wisdom to the wise and knowledge to the scholars. The king's heart is like a stream of water directed by the Lord. He guides it wherever he pleases. Heavenly Father, in this time of transition into the reign of King Charles III, we acknowledge your hand. We pray for our king that his heart may always incline to your will, his feet walk in your way, his words be wise, his power be exercised for the welfare of all the people of this land, and particularly for the most vulnerable. Give to his advisers wisdom and insight. We pray for all who serve in the name of the King, both nationally and locally here in Reigate and Banstead. Give them health and strength, wisdom and courage, that they may carry out their many duties in the welfare and best interests of all our people. May all who have power remember that they are your servants, and that your Son came not to be served, but to serve. Shape us as a nation and as a borough to be those who serve one another and seek the common good. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Hoff.
Buglers, ready? Buglers, sound the alert. Standard bearers, royal salute.
Yesterday, the Accession Council met at St James's Palace to proclaim our new sovereign. The flags, which have flown at half-mast since the Queen's death, were raised briefly to their full height to mark the start of His Majesty's reign. The Accession Council also made an order requiring High Sheriffs to cause the proclamation to be read in the areas of their jurisdiction. The High Sheriff of Surrey discharged that duty earlier today, and now it is my humble duty to bring the words of the proclamation to the residents of the borough of Reigate and Banstead. Honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, the proclamation of the accession, the mace will now be inverted. Whereas it has pleased Almighty God to call to his mercy our late sovereign, Lady Queen Elizabeth II, of blessed and glorious memory, by whose decease the crown of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland is solely and rightfully come to the Prince Charles Philip Arthur George, we, therefore, the Lords spiritual and temporal of this realm and members of the House of Commons, together with other members of Her Late Majesty's Privy Council and representatives of the realms and territories, aldermen and citizens of London, and others, do now hereby with one voice and consent of tongue and heart publish and proclaim that the Prince Charles Philip Arthur George is now, by the death of our late sovereign of happy memory, become our only lawful and rightful liege Lord Charles III, by the grace of God of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and of his other realms and territories, King, Head of the Commonwealth, Defender of the Faith, to whom we do acknowledge all faith and obedience with humble affection, beseeching God by whom kings and queens do reign to bless His Majesty with long and happy years to reign over us. Given at St. James's Palace this 10th day of September in the year of our Lord 2022. Please can I ask guests to be upstanding if you are able to do so. God save the King!
God save the King!
We will now show a video of the Town Hall flag being raised to celebrate the accession of His Majesty. And after the flag is raised, I will invite you all to sing the first verse of the National Anthem.
Bye.
I now invite you all to sing the first verse of the National Anthem. The words can be found in your programme. Tony Guthrie, Deputy Lieutenant, to call for three cheers for His Majesty the King.
Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, three cheers for His Majesty the King. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Please be seated. Honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending this momentous event. The recording and photos of this ceremony will be available on the Reigate and Banstead Borough Council website. The funeral of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II will be on Monday the 19th of September, and there will be a national minute silence at 11 a.m. on this day. Books of condolence are open here at the Harlequin and the Town Hall in Reigate and at the community centres in Banstead and Hawley. Once again, I thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us this afternoon. Now the mayoral party has departed, we're going to ask you all to leave kind of via one of the doors on your left, down at the front, or up at the rear. Our book of condolence here in the building, as mentioned by Mr. Mayor, is now open. If you'd like to sign that whilst you're here, staff in the foyer will direct you. Other than that, just to say thank you very much for spending your afternoon with us, and we look forward to seeing you again. Thank you.